Hello and welcome to Queersay with me, Andrew Kay, and my guest this week is the editor of G-Scene magazine, James Ledward.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to have you back in the UK, James. You've been in the States.
Yes, I've been in California. Had a great time. Was there when the Oscars was on. Did a few parties.
Did you?
Yes.
Excellent, excellent. And you also went to a clothing optional resort.
Oh, you wicked man.
What was that like?
Well, you know, it's a long time since I've been. We just went for the afternoon to use their swimming pool. And it was in Palm Springs, which is a place where a lot of older gentlemen, more mature gentlemen, retire to.
Like what we are.
Like what we are. And we were sitting around the pool, and this vision comes in, wearing a black leather hat and nothing else apart from two little leather bars on his arm.
Like a Tom of Finland drawing.
He's smoking a cigar that must have been that thick. And he went and sat at the end of the pool. He pulled a chair up, cocked one leg up on it, and started masturbating.
Good Lord.
And, you know, in my youth, I would have said, oh, yeah, I was quite mortified.
I'm not surprised. Not surprised. Let's read our first story and get away from that sordid. A former British swimmer comes out against trans athletes in women's sports. Now, this is Sharon Davis, and she's always been fairly vocal as a sports pundit, hasn't she?
She has, and that's the key thing. She is a pundit. Mm. And what worries me is how the people that are running sport on television, what's their protocols for dealing with this? Mm. Because I feel very uncomfortable about people that have got access to the media being allowed to say this stuff, and it goes unchallenged. And I was genuinely surprised. I was surprised when Navratilova said what she said last week. I was even more surprised with Sharon Davis. Because I always thought she was a very good girl and very sensible. And for me, there is no argument. You know, if somebody wants to compete as a trans woman in women's sport, they should be allowed to do it. And I don't buy into the argument that they have an advantage for having formerly been a man.
I think it's a difficult one. I think it's really hard to actually judge on this one because mm-hmm. there are going to be people who will have an advantage for having formerly been a man.
Yeah.
But so many other disadvantages in their lives, maybe that balances out.
But you know, it's like the whole Ian Thorpe had big feet, so he was able to swim faster than every other swimmer in the world. Is that an advantage? No, that's how the cookie crumbles.
Yeah.
And I just don't see it as an advantage. I wish they'd get on with it.
Maybe we're heading towards genderless sporting events.
Yeah,
where,
maybe, I don't know.
You know, maybe mixed gender football teams.
Yeah. Well, the Navratilova story broke while I was in America.
Yes.
And I have to say, it opened my eyes a little bit as to how further along the road the debate is in America on the trans issue. And it's made me even more alarmed at what is, you know, at the success Trump is having with rolling the rights of trans people back as quickly as he is doing.
Absolutely.
Because in my head, I thought, you know, they were behind us. They're not. They're well ahead of us. Which makes it even more confusing for me that Navratilova chose now, particularly, to say what she said.
It's interesting. Let's move on. NAT raised concerns about new prep places for gay men in London clinics being rationed. Now, this has been coming for bubbling away for the last few weeks.
Mm-hmm.
And it is a concern because it isn't that long since you and I think, spoke about the fact that they were increasing the number of places on the prep trial.
Yes, I just wish they'd get on with it. For me, this is just nonsense what's going on. The decision's been made that they're going to make these places available. And if we're not going to run a postcode lottery with regard to our national health, everybody should have access to this.
Absolutely.
And I can't move away from that position. And it was interesting because I was in the States.